So, hello everyone. I will be presenting my package called Roger. It aims to facilitate web scraping in R. Before that, a few words about myself. My full name is Mohamed Al-Fadeli Hadadan. I'm a PhD candidate in economics and I tweet under Mo Fadel. So, let's dive into an example right away. Here you can find a link to a web page that ranks the highest revenues in the cinema industry. Suppose I'm interested in extracting this information, all the titles of the movies in this web page. In Roger, you only need two elements, two inputs. So you need to take the link, the web page link, and the HTML or CSS element that references the needed information. So in this case, the titles. So what we can do, we can, for example, inspect and look for the tag, all right? Or we can just use a great tool called Selector Gadget, which gives you using a click, which is quite amazing. I mean, the CSS selector that you need. So you click here, you can see the highlight. You just have to copy this field and paste it into the Roger function. So the most basic function in Roger is scrap. It takes at least two arguments, the link of the web page and the node. So we have copied the node here. We have seen how to do that, the web page. And we use scrap, link node. And we got our 200 information. So just to check out, I made the head data so we can see that we have Avengers, Avatar, Titanic, which correspond. Why did we get 200 observations? Because the web page displays only 200. Suppose I want to, for example, extract all the titles, like from 1 to 1,000. It's possible and it's quite easy to do so. You just have to find a pattern in your link here. So like so, suppose I click next page. You can see that I have 200 here, which states that the web page displays movies after 200. And then if I click next page, I got 400, 600, I think until 800. So each web page increments with 200 the number of observation. We can just using the scrap function in conjunction with the past function or the glue package, we can just replace this variable element with a vector and we got the four links. And we can scrap all the website. All right. So there is in here. You have an example. I have used the glue package. So I have modified the changing element with a sequence of numbers from 0 to 800 with an incrementation of 200, of course. And I have run it in scrap. I got 1,000 elements. So it's that easy. You don't have, you don't need to use any map or for loop or whatever. So we can also use a function in Roger called table scrap. You can just provide the link of the web page where there is an HTML table and you get it. It's that simple. But now suppose we have a website. But the table is not in HTML format. Here, for example, if you go to the IMDb website, you want, let's say, to extract the title of each movie, his rating, and the released year. But of course, you want to do that in a tabular format, like you want a data frame with each column, with the first column, let's say the title, the second column the rating, and the third column the year. You can extract with Roger a table directly from a website using the tidyscrap function. So what it does, the tidyscrap function, is it takes a vector of CSS or HTML elements and the corresponding names, and it will extract directly a table for you in R. So that's quite interesting. I think I'm running out of time, so thank you very much. And if you have any question, please feel free to reach out. And don't hesitate to check out the documentation. There are many other functions that you can be helpful when scrapping data. Thank you again.